Jared Polin, FroKnowsPhoto.com. Thank you for watching this video, because in the next few minutes, I'm going to show you exactly how you can learn almost everything you need to know to start shooting fantastic videos with your DSLR faster than you ever thought possible. It doesn't matter if you're a seasoned professional, beginner, or hobbyist photographer. If you want to take your DSLR video skills to another level and produce professional, world-class videos, keep watching. The best part is that what you're about to learn will work for you even if you're a one-man band, without a crew, or on a shoestring budget. But before we get to that, let me ask you a few questions. Are you new to DSLR video? Have you had a DSLR for a while but haven't ventured into shooting video because you're just not sure where to start? Are you a seasoned photographer who wants to add DSLR video to your arsenal? Do you want to make more money with your DSLR? Or do you want to learn how professional filmmakers shoot and produce video with a DSLR? If you answered yes to any of those questions, then you're in luck, because I've teamed up with award-winning filmmaker Todd Wolf to finally create a solution to learn exactly how to shoot and produce breathtaking video with your DSLR in a matter of days. You don't have to deal with months or years of bad results and frustrating experimentation like I did. You also don't have to waste a ton of time trying to filter through the inaccurate and scattered tutorials available around the internet. And you won't have to spend a ton of time and money in school taking classes to learn everything we've included in this guide. We have created this 6-hour comprehensive video guide that not only teaches you the fundamentals and basics of DSLR video, but puts them into practice by joining Todd and I on location for 4 real-world video shoots that include a music video, commercial interview, short film, and even a YouTube production. But what's great is that this guide isn't the stiff, boring, and useless training you've seen on other websites and in college courses or books. We do it in a fun and informative way. And after you watch this guide, you'll have all of the knowledge you need to start shooting impressive DSLR video today. But why wait? Let me give you some free tips right now, straight from the guide. Enjoy.
Yellow ball, I got the yellow ball.
Oh, all right. I think I ate the most balls there. So why are we using Hungry Hungry Hippos to demonstrate anything? Well, we're going to get into frame rate. Our cameras have the ability to be set at different frame rates, and that's what Todd's going to explain. So what are the different frame rates we're going to be working with?
The general frame rates that everybody's going to find in their cameras is 24 frames per second, 30 frames per second, and 60 frames per second.
So what you're saying is that at 24 frames, we have literally 24 individual still images and 30, there's 60 still frames that all make up the video?
That's exactly right.
So what is that giving us?
24 frames per second is going to give you that cinematic film look. It's going to give you a motion blur. We've all grown up watching movies shot at 24 frames per second, and a lot of guys tend to gravitate towards 24 frames just to imitate that look.
So that gives you a certain look that may be good for one thing, but maybe 30 is better for something else.
30 frames is going to give us a more realistic look. There's actually more frames there capturing more action, but it's going to give you that video look.
So what are we going to do here to demonstrate?
We're going to stick with that cinematic movie-like look. So 24 frames per second is where we're going to live on all these examples. The only thing we're going to change is the shutter speed. So let's start off with this 1/50th of a second and see what that looks like.
What we're going to do here is show you how shutter speed affects what's going on in the image. We're going to use a metronome so we have something that's constant and moving. We've already locked in the settings for the camera because all we're focusing in on right here is what's going to happen when we change the shutter speed. All right, let's see what happens with this metronome as an example.
All right, and we're rolling and action. Now, this is a very pleasing image. This is that cinematic look we were talking about. Great place to be.
This looks all right. What's going to happen if we slow it down to 1/30th of a second?
Let's see what it looks like. So we're down to 1/30th, and we're recording. Now, what's going to happen here is we're just picking up more of that motion blur. Not a terrible thing, but it's definitely something to be aware of if you push it down that far.
So we've shown you a lot of different lights that you can use for your setups, but we haven't shown an actual setup, and Todd's going to tell us about a simple one right here.
We're going to do a classic setup called a 3-point lighting scheme. It's got your key, it's got your fill, and it's got your hair light.
So what I want you guys to know is that we've already locked in the settings for the camera. This isn't about the settings of the camera and what lens and all of that. It's all about the lighting. So Todd, what are we doing here?
First thing we're gonna do is we're gonna turn on our key light. That's our main source of light. It's gonna be the strongest light in the whole scene. So let's turn that on and see what it looks like.
So while Todd's doing that, I wanna let you know that if you just have one setup, I know that this is called three-point lighting, but we want you to know that with just one light, you can still make this happen. We just wanna show you that one, two, three lights and how that all works together, just so that you have an idea that you can build off of that for the future. So we just showed you guys a lot of different options that you have to get audio into the camera, but there's one mistake that I made when I first started out because I didn't know any better, and that was how to set the audio levels in my camera. I set it to auto, and auto may not be the right choice. Why is auto not the right choice, Todd?
Well, it would be great if the camera did all the work. Unfortunately, when it's set to auto, when it's real quiet and nobody's talking, it looks for sound. So it raises your recording level and you get a lot of hiss. Next thing you know, somebody starts talking again and it compresses that audio to try to keep up with all the different levels.
Right, so basically what's happening there is the camera is set to auto and it's bouncing up, it's bouncing down based off of just whatever audio is there. So if you have some quiet times, it's really gonna raise those levels. You're gonna hear a lot of hiss, and that isn't good. I hear a lot of hiss in a lot of my early videos, and that really is the reason why. So what is the way around it?
Well, the first thing you gotta do is get out of auto and go to manual.
If you enjoyed that, be sure to watch until the end because we'll give you another free look inside our video shoots. But before we go any further, if you're not familiar with who I am, my name is Jared Polin, AKA The Fro from froknowsphoto.com. I've been a professional photographer since I was 15 years old, and during my career, I've shot photos for Rolling Stone, the Philadelphia Flyers, Perry Farrell of Jane's Addiction, Modest Yahoo, and hundreds of well-known musicians, tech visionaries, business owners, and celebrities. For the past 4 years, I've been creating fun and informative videos that have helped hundreds of thousands of photographers and videographers of all skill levels. My training videos have been featured on sites like Digital Photography School, DP Review, Petapixels, F-Stoppers, and many more. I've been a photographer for over 20 years, and when my first DSLR gave me the ability to shoot video, I thought the transition would come naturally. I was wrong, but I didn't know why yet. At first, I thought shooting video was easy. I set up the camera, set my exposure exactly how I would set it if I were taking a still, and then press the record button. Little did I know, I wasn't even close to doing things properly. I didn't know what a frame rate was and why it was important. I didn't understand that the exposure triangle was totally different for video, and I had no idea how important audio was. I quickly discovered that photography and videography are completely different animals, and just because you're proficient at one doesn't mean you're proficient at the other, which I found out the hard way. Here are some questions I had. How should the different settings be used for the look or style I want? How should I set up the scenes to keep the viewer engaged? What are the hidden rules of shooting amazing video that don't apply to still photography? How do I minimize the time I spend editing in post-production? How do I get the sound just right for any situation? What do I do as far as composition and storytelling to make the video memorable? And a bunch of other things like what gear should I use, what lighting equipment I needed, and how to do all of this on my own without a crew. I tried reading articles and watching videos from around the internet, but the information out there is scattered and often low quality. It made learning how to do it professionally on my own nearly impossible. At this point, I knew I needed guidance from someone who was more skilled at video production to show me all the things I was doing wrong and to guide me towards better video. Otherwise, I would continue wasting time shooting videos that were just good enough. So what did I do? When the time came to film some very large projects, I sought out a seasoned professional who was just as good at video production as I am at photography, and that was Todd Wolf. I hired him to shoot and produce both of my video guides, the Fronos Photo Guide to Getting Out of Auto and the Fronos Photo Flash Guide. If you've ever seen either of them, you know how high quality Todd's video work is. I ended up learning more from Todd about video in a few short weeks than I was able to learn in the previous 4 years on my own. So, after creating the first two guides and helping tens of thousands of people understand the fundamentals of photography and flash photography, people started to ask me, how do I shoot video with my DSLR? And that's why I teamed up with Todd and gathered all this information in one place to answer that exact question. And once you've seen what we've created, it's going to dramatically cut down the learning curve for teaching you how to capture video with your DSLR. So here's another sneak peek inside. So we're out on location at a bowling alley, and not only are we gonna do something pretty cool, but I have my bowling shoes on because I'm ready to bowl. But Todd, what are we really here to do?
We are here to shoot an EPK, which is an electronic press kit. So this could be for any corporate client, any business out there, and a great way to make a couple bucks. Mr. Dave Leno back here, he's an avid bowler. He's looking for an EPK to help promote himself and how knowledgeable he is.
Sure, and another thing that an EPK can be used for musicians, for any business owner, you're telling the story of what they do in an easily consumable piece of content that they can put anywhere and use it pretty much as an advertisement. So you have the clipboard here. What are we talking about?
I got a clipboard here. I have got a shot list first and foremost. Last night, I kind of just thought out everything I want to get. Not cutting off creativity whatsoever. We're gonna be inspired while we're here to do some extra things, but at least I've got a roadmap and I'm not gonna miss critical things.
Yeah, remember when we talked about pre-production? That's what you have to do to prepare yourself. Todd, what are some more rules we're gonna get into?
Well, some good things I wanna talk about now are coverage and the almighty 180 rule.
Now, this 180 rule is something that I just ruined at the very beginning, but it's something that I made the mistake once and it never happens again. So that's why we're here to show you the examples to see what a good use of the 180 rule is and what it looks like if we break it.
So let me just give you the basics. We've got a camera above us here, and between the two characters, there's an axis between us. There's an eye line between us. We don't want to cross that eye line with our camera. We want everything to be on one side or the other. Right now, we've got all of our cameras on this side. That's generally where you want to keep them. It helps the audience understand where things are relative to one another. Now, if we cross that line, which we will show an example of, it will disorient the audience. Can you break the rule? Absolutely. But know the rules, and then you can break them.
All right, Todd, I see you have the slider set up. What is going on here?
Well, I'm going to come in here for a two shot. Kind of tried to fake it here when I swung it around. I think that'll give me good movement to come into this shot, but this is going to give us a really cool effect while getting both of them in one shot.
So go over the two shot again.
Two shot is, obviously, we've got two folks here that we're going to get in the same frame at the same time. This isn't singles. This is a two shot.
So we referred to dirty and clean and before, but in this case,
it would be clean, except I decided to grab some glasses from behind the bar, stack them here, so I put a nice foreground element as I'm sliding back and forth, and it's gonna look really cool.
So before we can get to shoot, we had the scratch audio coming from the camera before on the first shot, but
yep.
Now that we're in a two shot, what are we doing to get better audio?
Well, now that I'm tighter, I actually was able to rig my Rode mic here on a boom pole over top of them. It's not gonna be the best sound right now, but it's the best for the shot I'm doing right now. It's not pointing at either one of them directly, so it's gonna get a little bit of both of them pretty good, but not the best. Where I'm gonna get the best sound is when I go in for close-ups.
So what's the lighting setup that we have right now?
Well, the bulbs we have are daylight, and our cameras are set to daylight. Under the daylight setting, you've got your cloudy and you've got your shady. That's just a variation of the daylight. So as of right now, our whites are white.
Right, so if we popped up this white card, we would see that everything should be pretty white.
Mm-hmm. Absolutely. Now, we also have some other variations in here. We've got some tungsten bulbs in here. So let's switch to tungsten so we can kind of show what's going to happen while we're still in daylight settings on the camera.
Sure.
Boom. So we are awash in a beautiful orange glow.
Right, so basically what's switched here is we just changed the light to tungsten balanced light, but left the camera set to the daylight white balance. So what would we do here to get the proper white balance?
I mean, we have tungsten lights on now, so we should switch our camera to tungsten.
All right, so let's do that.
All right.
So there's another look inside. To sum it up, we're gonna give you all the tools and fundamentals you need to go out into the world today and create amazing video content with your DSLR. There are a lot of misconceptions about what's necessary to shoot DSLR video. Like, I need a top-of-the-line DSLR camera and lots of expensive equipment to shoot quality video. Not true. In fact, on set, Todd used an entry-level DSLR camera to film his real-world shoots. People will also tell you that DSLR video is so complicated that the only way to learn is to go to college and spend tens of thousands of dollars on tuition and years of your time. This is also not true. We've taken our years of real-world experience and condensed it down into a 6-hour comprehensive video guide that won't cost you thousands of dollars. Lastly, the biggest misconception of all is that you need a big crew to shoot quality DSLR video. This is absolutely not the case. That is why we structured this guide to show you that you can do this on your own as a one-man band. When we say you can be a one-man band, we really mean that you can do it all. You'll be able to set up any camera, lock in your settings, set up the lights, shoot the video, record the audio, add dimension with camera movement, direct the whole thing, and much more. Todd and I both wish we had a guide like this when we first started shooting DSLR video. It would have saved us a lot of money and years of frustration. It doesn't matter if you want to shoot videos of your kids, interviews, weddings, your own YouTube videos, movies, anything. Even if you want to make money, we've got you covered. In this guide, we pull back the curtains and not only teach you everything you need to know, we also take you on set so you can see how it all works as we're shooting video in the real world. You'll literally be able to see our exact camera settings, equipment setup, lighting, all of it. I really mean it when I say that anyone can shoot stunning DSLR video with any budget and any skill level. This course is a no-holds-barred, all-access pass to Todd and my expertise. We seriously hold nothing back. It's like having us as your personal mentor at a fraction of the price. Better yet, you can watch these videos over and over again. So join us on the inside of the Fronos Photo Guide to DSLR Video and fast track your learning to finally create quality DSLR video quickly and efficiently on your own. Normally, this guide would sell for $197, but for a very limited time, we're offering you a special discounted price. And when you order the Fronos Photo Guide to DSLR Video today, you'll also get these fast action bonuses. My YouTube tips. I give you the exact model and mentality I follow for being successful on YouTube. Todd's editing tips. Todd gives you an entire video of bonus tips and tricks that he uses as a professional editor. Our DSLR video PDF checklist. This list will make sure you have everything you need before you get out on a shoot. Never leave home without it. And finally, we've created assignments. These assignments, both basic and advanced, are meant as homework because the only way you'll become a better filmmaker will be to get out there and shoot. Remember, you won't pay the normal price of $197 today. Click the Add to Cart button below this video to claim your discount on the brand new Fronos Photo Guide to DSLR Video for just $97. You can also purchase it as a DVD for a few extra dollars. We're so confident that you're going to love this video guide and get so much value out of it that we're offering the Fronos Photo Iron Fro Guarantee for a full 60 days. What does that mean exactly? Well, if you don't think this guide was worth every penny, we'll refund all of your money. There is no risk to you. That's how confident we are that this guide is going to accelerate your DSLR video skills faster than you ever thought possible. Thank you for watching this video. I look forward to seeing the amazing videos you're about to create. Click the Add to Cart button below to get started. Jared Polin, FronosPhoto.com. See ya.